In this episode, I have 5 easy crafts to recreate in your own craft rooms. Some of them have glass, some of them have wood, and one is a really high-end looking snowflake that I saw at a nearby boutique that you just have to try. All right, now let's get crafting. For this DIY, we are going to be using some of these wood planks and these 2 different fonts for rub-on stickers. Now I'm going to start by making my sides and my bottom of my box, and I'm going to just trace where I need to cut the sides of my box. This is really easy to do. I'm using my miter box to be able to cut these pieces. You could technically cut them with your scissors too, but honestly, it would just tear your scissors up. So I'm using my miter box because I have it here on hand. Then I'm gonna add some hot glue and some wood glue, and I'm gonna just bring all of the sides together. So once I had the 2 long sides, I went ahead and added on the ends of the box. Doing the same exact thing, adding in the hot glue and the wood glue for that long-term, short-term hold. Make sure you get all the extra off the side so it's not spilling out and you have a nice clean finished side. Then I painted the boxes a light gray and a beautiful forest green. On the light gray, I used some of those rub-on stickers. I love these things because they're so cool. It reminds me of my days when I was a scrapbooker. And then on the green box, I decided to paint on the word winter. So the gray box says, baby, it's cold outside. And then the green box says winter. I think together these are so pretty. And in just a second, they're going to start to come together where you're going to see me stacking them and doing some really cool stuff with them. So just take your time if you're doing any hand painting. I always love this because it's so therapeutic for me. I always trace it out first with my pencil and then I go over it with a fine tip brush with my white paint. Now we're going to make something special for the box. I'm going to take some of these snowflakes that they have at the Dollar Tree, add one of these craft long sticks to it, and then I'm going to go ahead and let that dry and go ahead and work on putting in my foam into the boxes. So I just added some hot glue at the bottom and I'm just putting them all down into place, and then I'm coming in with some greenery and some snowflakes that I put on those sticks and just really dressed it up, and it just looks so cute together. This DIY is really easy for anyone who's wanting to try some crafts this Christmas season. Go ahead and take 2 of these different glass stem candle votives that they have at the Dollar Tree over in their home decor area, 2 of these glass jars that they also have there for candles, and then 2 of their candles that they have. Now, to make sure that the glass stays on long term, you're going to take some E6000. You're gonna create a circular pattern right there, and then you're gonna leave some spaces in between to add in the hot glue. That hot glue is gonna dry over time and it's gonna allow that E6000 to really seal and bond the glass together. Now I like to kind of roll it around on there to make sure everything was nice and glued down. And then once they were all in place, go ahead and take whatever ribbon it is that you like. You can even add some greenery, some berries to this. I kept it really clean and simple to make it look that high-end Pottery Barn look. And I'm just gonna take this really pretty ribbon from the Dollar Tree and add a bow and some tails. Then simply add in your candles and you're ready to display. Over the last weekend, I was at a boutique store and I came across these gorgeous 3D ornaments that were snowflakes. And I knew that we could make these so much cheaper with the Dollar Tree ones. They were actually selling for $20 a piece. And today we're gonna make this for like $1.25 because we have to count in the paint, right? And the snow stuff we're gonna put on it. So maybe even like $1.50 for each one versus $20. So you can see here that I found a pack of snowflakes at the Dollar Tree. There were 3 inside the pack, and I'm gonna add on some E6000 and some hot glue for that long-term, short-term hold. And then what we're gonna do is we are gonna take one of the snowflakes and we're gonna cut it straight in half. And it cuts really easy, just take your time doing it. And we are gonna take that glue and we're gonna just nestle in that snowflake we cut in half on one side. This is gonna allow the snowflake to look 3D and dimensional. And then once that's dry from the hot glue holding it in place, you're then gonna flip it over and you're gonna do it on the same thing on the other side. Cut the snowflake in half, that was the third one in the box, and then go ahead and just glue them all together. This turned out so much better than I even thought it would. And I took it outside at this point and spray painted it gray because the one I saw in the boutique that was so cute, it was a metal snowflake that they had added some white paint to and all kinds of little snow crystals and pretty things. So right now what we're gonna do is we're gonna take some snow from the Dollar Tree and then these little balls that are supposed to look like these little snowballs. Listen, friends, if you've worked with these before, you will know that they statically cling to everything. So I have learned that the best thing to do is to put it in a Ziploc bag. You flick the side so it goes down because you're releasing that static cling to it. And then I just fold it down enough to be able to create, you know, a place where I can work with them. Last year, I tried to put them inside of a bowl and they went berserk. They went everywhere. So do yourself a favor. If you're gonna work with them, put them in a Ziploc bag. Then I'm gonna add some paint and some hot glue and I'm gonna just keep dipping it inside of that bag to get the snow on it. So once I had all of that all over, I wanted you guys to see. I get questions all the time from friends asking if my hands ever get dirty because I clean them quite frequently for you all so my hands look clean in the video. But yes, I am actually a very, very messy crafter. Not meaning my space on my table, I like to keep my space clean, but my hands do get dirty quite a bit and then I just clean them with wipes. I keep those by my desk. Okay, so now I'm gonna move on to the ribbon part. There are a couple different options from the Dollar Tree. Right now they have this beautiful red and white gingham ribbon and then they have the black and white gingham ribbon. And I love these ribbons. They also have lace and some twine, so you have a lot of different options to be able to hang these snowflakes up with. But I'm gonna go with the red because I'm doing the red and white this year, like I said, in my home. And then what you do is you just tie a nice little slip knot up at the top to hang it up. And then at the base, I'm gonna go ahead and not tie a knot. I actually wanted to not make it too bulky. So I just kind of folded over the ribbon and I pinched it down with some hot glue to make it stay in place. You can do whatever you want at the top part, but that's just how I did it because I wanted to make it look nice and flat. Now you're gonna see me getting every single drop out of my paint because I am a true believer in every drop. I don't want any drop to be wasted in my paint. So I'm just getting out the last of it, which is why I was, you know, showing that part that I had filmed. And now I'm gonna go back in to conceal where I glued it at the top. I wanna make it look a little bit cleaner so it looks like that high-end boutique look. And I just added some paint, some more hot glue, and then I'm gonna dip it back down inside to make sure that I get that look that I'm going for that is nice and clean and organized. And then anything else that's extra on there, you're just gonna pull off any of those strings from the hot glue and just tap it a couple times to make sure you don't have any things that are flying away and making a mess in your house. And then you're ready to hang it up and display in your home. This DIY is super simple and there's been so many different variations of it, but I wanted to do something different because I came up with this technique at the beginning of this Christmas season. I love adding this texture to my DIYs, these little bumps. And I know they're just a little bit of bling that a lot of people use on scrapbooking, but these are so cool when you see what we're gonna do with them. So I'm just taking them and going along all the edges of my plate and then as well on my candle stem. So I'm gonna go around the middle part and then I'm gonna come down to the base and also go around the base. Now we're gonna be doing a whitewash with these and it is going to look so cool. Instead of doing the regular distressing that we do, we're gonna end up doing it with white and it's gonna look so cool. Here I am busting open a new bottle of E6000. That last one that you saw in my last video, I was just squeezing the life out of that thing, trying to make sure I got every drop. So I like to do it in three parts. I do three different areas of the E6000 and then I come back in the opened areas and I add in the hot glue in those other three areas to make sure that it's nice and sealed. The hot glue is for a short-term hold and the the E6000s for a long-term hold. Once you have that all done, take it outside and spray paint it all the color that you want. I went with red because that's the color I'm doing for our home this Christmas season. And now we're gonna start working on that white paint. So I'm just putting very little, not too crazy, because we're gonna be wiping away the majority of it. We want the white to fall in between all of those bumps and those grooves, because it adds the prettiest detail. Then when you're all done with the white part, go ahead and take some of your glossy Mod Podge and go ahead and just rub that all over the whole thing and then really let it dry. Now I definitely would not put cookies on this, but you could if you put down a little cloth with it, but this could definitely be the cutest thing to put on little treats or some candles. So pretty for Christmas. I took two blocks of 2x4. One was a little bit taller than the other one. One was 12 inches high and the other one was 9 inches high. And then I'm just gonna paint with green and actually pink. Now you could do red, but I loved the inspiration photo where it had pink and I thought it just looked really cute because you can add the red and it makes it just look, I don't know, really pretty. So once you've got the green and the pink painted on, you're then going to go to the top on the other side and paint 1/4 of it black. And that's going to be for the hat on the nutcracker, and repeat the process on the pink. Then you're going to need to mix orange and white to get a nice peachy color for the face of the nutcracker. And then you're just going to go around the sides and the front. You're not going to need to go around the back because that's going to be covered with hair. Technically, you don't even need to go on the sides, but I just, again, I like to make things look store-bought. And so I thought, well, let me just do it anyway. Plus, I really like painting. Once those all dry, you're going to take that glittery red ribbon, again from the Dollar Tree, and you're going to go around the top of the hat of the nutcracker. Now, the trick is you want to make sure that you're showing a little bit of that black paint because it's going to make it look like his hat brim. Then I'm going to take some really thin white ribbon I also got at the Dollar Tree, and I cut them small in size to fit. I don't have the exact measurement on this one, but you're going to create 4 of those. Hot glue them down into place, and then you are going to move on to the hair of the nutcracker. Now you're going to take some of this car cleaning fabric that you can get in the car section of the Dollar Tree, cut a strip of it off, and then you're going to just work on hot gluing around the nutcracker. Now as I'm putting it on, I'm actually folding it under so it has a nice finished look, and then I'm going to just keep going all the way around. When I get to the end, I'm gonna make sure I go all around, and then I'm going to fold it all in, just like so, and hot glue it into place. This fabric is super fuzzy and fluffy, so it's really great for the Nutcracker's hair and his little goatee. Then I added some buttons that I had on hand. You can use whatever you want on this, some little bling pieces, some buttons, brads, whatever you might want to add to it. Now we're going to move on to its face. First, you're going to draw a line for his brow area and then come down for his nose, which is a rectangular shape. At that stage, you're ready to move on to his mustache. It goes right underneath his nose, and you're just going to make sure the ends of that mustache is curled in because that is just so stinking cute. I love little mustaches on my nutcrackers. Then for his mouth, it's just a rounded edged rectangle right underneath his mustache. Then for his eyes, I use the back of my paintbrush all the time for circles. I just like it so much more. It's really easy to do it this way. So I'm just going to add some white right underneath that brow line so that it can help me line up where I want the eyeballs to be. Then I move on to doing the teeth, also with the back of my paintbrush. I just got a little bit on there and then slowly made the teeth lines. Now to help the eye stand out a little bit more, you're going to take your thin brush and you're just going to go right underneath the whites of the eyes, and with the back of the paintbrush again, do two dots for the eyes. Now I wanted to add a little bit more fluff on the Nutcracker's face, so I took another piece of the fabric and just kind of rolled it up, as you can see here, and glued it down into place. Then using red, I'm going to make its rosy cheeks. And then to add a little bit more texture and pattern to it, because as of right now it's kind of plain, I took some of this gingham ribbon that I picked up from Walmart and then wrapped it around the top of the hat. And don't forget the eyebrows. I actually almost forgot the eyebrows and filming them, and then I thought, he looks kind of funny, there's something missing, and then I realized, oh wait, the eyebrows. When you're all done with the eyebrows, you're then going to do one last thing. You're going to create a line across the teeth to make it look like a nutcracker. Thanks so much for watching this video today. I hope you enjoyed these 5 ideas using supplies from the Dollar Tree and just some things that I had on hand here in my craft room. Leave a comment down below to let me know which one you like and which one you think you will try in your own craft room this season. Please do give this a thumbs up and click the subscribe button if you are new here to my channel. I'm going to recommend a couple of videos right here if you enjoyed this one. Until the next episode, bye friends!